Good morning. Welcome to St. Charles Presbyterian Church in St. Charles, Missouri. We welcome you to Senior Recognition Day. Normally, on Mother's Day, we do Youth Sunday, but because of coronavirus and our social distancing, we are only having two of our three seniors come and share with you today their gifts and from their hearts. And so we're excited for both Sam and Emma. And I do want to say happy birthday to Sam. He turned 18, I believe, today or yesterday, right? And so we're so grateful that he's here. And so part of the birthday gift that he's receiving is that he gets to share with us this day. I also want to say happy Mother's Day to all you women that are watching this day on Mother's Day. For me, Mother's Day just isn't about someone who's had a baby and is a mother in that sense, but anyone who has cared for us over the years deserves our honor and our love and our support. And so we give you all praise. Any woman that is part of our church family and others, we think about you today. Again, I'm excited that we have two of our seniors, Claire and Sam, and they want to share what God means to them because of this church family. And so I'm excited about that. We do have a couple of just a brief announcements. We do want to keep telling you that we have a blue box outside for Salvation Army near the narthex doors, or we also have an ability to continue our partnership with Fish Food Pantry. And so if you buy something and you don't want to drop it off at church, the deacons will come by your house and pick it up and take it to Fish for you. Or you could do that yourself. You could buy your own food pantry items, and they're really needing hygiene kits this week. So check out your bulletin, it lets you know. We also want to again lift up that on May 21st, our session, our elders are meeting to talk about reopening at some point in the near future. We don't have a date and we don't anticipate a date at this point, but we're going to talk about it and what that means for us. We want you to continue to buy your script cards. If you don't have a script order card, where we receive a percentage back, please let the church office know, and we will mail that to you, and then you can fill that out and get that back to us. And so appreciate all those that continue script, especially as restaurants and other places are opening. This allows you to use that. And the final thing is, if you have any needs whatsoever, please let us know. You could call me, you could text me, you could call the church office, you could email the church office, but let us know anything that you might need. We have a lot of people that are willing to shop for you. We record our services every week. If you don't have a DVD player, you're not going to see this, but we have CDs that we will offer you so you could listen to the service. So we are grateful that we have an opportunity this day to continue worshiping in spirit and truth. It's my prayer as your pastor and your friend that you'll continue to live a wise and safe life and find ways for Jesus to use your hearts and hands to share his good news with others. God does call us to celebrate this day, a day full of new possibilities, a time to praise the resurrection and the life that we find in Jesus Christ. So let us worship God together.
And good morning.
Good morning.
Let us gather as one family and as God's children, joyful that in Christ we can find safety in God's house as we live out the abundant life God gives us. Please join as we share our lives together in our call to worship. We gather today as your people, different and diverse, O God.
Young and old, rule followers and rule breakers, liberals and conservatives, and every distinction in between.
We gather together as your beloved, sisters and brothers of Jesus.
We are a people who are called to unity, justice, and grace, who live together and are bound by God's love.
We gather together as children of the covenant of love.
We offer this time of worship to you, O God.
As we listen to Christ's words, let us become one.
Jesus says to us this day, I came that you may have and enjoy life and have it in abundance. We are blessed that our church is a safe place where we can grow and heal and laugh and learn who and what Christ wants us to become. And even though we are watching the service online and we are apart physically, we are still God's family. So let's pause this worship service and say hi to our brothers and sisters in faith as we pass the peace of Christ with one another through our online messaging. Let us share the abundant life of Jesus Christ with the sign of peace. The peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us prepare our hearts for God's word. Let us pray. Living, giving God, Give us open hearts, as open and eager as when we were children, listening to the stories our parents and teachers read to us. Give us open ears to listen to your word that calls us to find safety, healing, and growth in you through our church. Fill us with your spirit of life, compassion, and peace. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Our epistle lesson is from Paul's letter to the Church of Rome, Romans chapter 12, verses 4 through 13. Hear now the safety rules God gives to us as Christians to live the abundant life. This is the good news gospel of the living God. Use good sense and measure yourself by the amount of faith that God has given you. A body is made up of many parts, and each of them has its own use. That is how it is with us. There are many of us, but each are part of the body of Christ, as well as part of one another. God has also given each of us different gifts to use. If we can prophesy, we should do it according to the amount of faith we have. If we can serve others, we should serve. If we can teach, we should teach. If we can encourage others, we should encourage them. If we can give, we should do so generously. If we are leaders, we should do our best. If we are good to others, we should do it cheerfully. Be sincere in your love for others. Hate everything that is evil and hold tight to everything that is good. Love each other as brothers and sisters and honor others more than you do yourself. Never give up. Eagerly follow the Holy Spirit and serve the Lord. Let your hope make you glad. Be patient in time of trouble and never stop praying. Take care of the people who need you and welcome strangers into your home. This is God's safety lesson so that we can live an abundant life. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Our gospel lesson that we chose to highlight our church and our seniors this day comes to us from the Gospel of John, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. And we're looking at the 13th chapter, verses 31 through 35. John 13, 31 through 35. Now hear the good news message of what it means to be a church. Jesus said this, "Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. And if God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer, and you will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. So before I leave, I want to leave you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I've loved you, you should also love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples. By this, everyone will know that you are my church, if you have love for one another. Let us pray. Almighty and gracious God, it is a privilege to worship you this day in the safety and support of our church family. May our praise be joyful. May our hearts be turned toward you. May our souls be satisfied with the waters of your word. In the sharing of Emma Claire and Sam's story, we give you all glory and praise and gratitude this day forevermore. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I see your power in the moonlight. Good morning. Never in my life did I think that I would be giving this speech under these circumstances. This pandemic has made my senior year interesting, to say the least, and I am sad that I cannot see you all sitting before me. Still, I consider it an honor to stand before you virtually today and talk about what this church has meant to me. I first came to St. Charles Presbyterian Church when I was 10 years old. Before that, my dad was a member of St. Peter's Catholic Church, and my mom was a member of Harvester Christian Church. In many ways, I feel that attending different churches as a kid gave me an advantage that most 10-year-olds don't have. It allowed me to see that although people may have different ideas and different ways of worshiping, we all believe in the same God and can learn a lot from each other's different experiences. Because in the end, God is everywhere. However, that often led me to wonder where God was for me. And I think our family came to realize that we needed a compromise. We needed a place where we could all worship together and feel God's presence. We needed a church that felt like home. And that calling led us here. All my life, I've felt like a wanderer. I've always had a different way of thinking and perceiving things. Even as a kid, I struggled with the intense need to have a deeper understanding of things. However, I quickly learned that not everyone thinks like that. I've been judged a lot for thinking differently. And before I came to this church, I struggled to find where I fit in. It wasn't until I heard what Ronnie said while giving communion one day that I found that place. He said, "All are welcome." From that moment on, I knew that I could come to Ronnie about anything. And we often disagreed, especially when he was trying to help me through confirmation. God bless him. The truth is, when I came to this church, I didn't know who I was. But as I listened to what Ronnie preached and grew alongside the people in this church, I realized that I was accepted and loved here, simply for being me. People have often asked me, "How do you find time to volunteer for everything at our church?" And as much as I would love for people to believe that I'm a deacon and a choir / contemporary member purely out of the goodness of my heart, I would be lying if I didn't tell them I do it because I love it, but mostly because I need it. I needed this church. I needed a place where I could come every week and be loved by people like Margaret Osborne and Mary Kay Lyon. I needed a place where people like Angie Southard would listen to me and value my opinions. And I needed a place to laugh and joke with people like Paul York and Howard Seeds. These people, along with my mom and dad, have shaped me greatly into becoming the person that I am today. And while I am immensely grateful for people like them, and many more at this church, there are a few select individuals I have found guidance and friendship in over these past years where I never expected to find it. Aaron White, Sam Gnolpho, Jacob York, and Zach Southard have given me many gifts over the years, the most common one being laughter. Through countless nights attending youth group, mission trips, lock-ins, and texting during services we were supposed to be listening to. Sorry, hey. Ronnie. These four boys have become some of my closest, most valued friends. At first, I wasn't really sure what to make of them. I can remember coming home after youth group and confirmation and telling my mom, "They're just so crazy." And they are. The five of us have gotten into lots of trouble. One time I remember distinctly was on our mission trip to Chicago. We went out to eat at Giordano's, a pizza place in the city, and I have to admit I was very concerned one of them was going to burn the place down trying to light the napkins on fire. We all got our pizza, and when we were finished eating, I asked the waiter if we could have separate checks. He not so politely informed me that that was not possible, and I told him that was okay, until I realized that none of them had enough cash to cover their meals, and I was the only one with a debit card. Now, in Jacob's defense, Paul had put him on a plane with no money, sleeping bag, or toothbrush. But since I was already supplying two of those things for him, I can admit I was a little hesitant to provide money as well. And my hesitation grew quickly when I got the bill. Needless to say, we hadn't been out of the restaurant for 2 minutes when I received a very loud phone call from my father asking me why there was a $267 pizza bill on my debit card. But besides all these crazy shenanigans we had gotten ourselves into, they were there for me during the hard times too, especially Zach. Zach Southern is one of the most selfless people that I know. He has listened to my rants over dinners we skipped rehearsal to go to, laughed with me, and been there for me when I had really difficult things that I needed to tell someone about. I owe a huge portion of who I have become today, not only to this church, but to him. And being a youth deacon with him has created lifelong memories that I will never forget. While I love every person at this church, no one has been a truer example to me of what I think Jesus is like. Kind, forgiving, brave, true to himself, and accepting of others for who they are and who they will become. I look back at myself 8 years ago, and I see someone searching for acceptance. I can honestly tell you that I have found that here, in this building, and through all of you. You all have shaped me into the person who I am now, more confident, caring, and brave. In the fall, I will attend Lindenwood University to earn my Bachelor's of Science in Fashion Business and Entrepreneurship with a minor in graphic design. And I'm sure I will find many people who will make campus feel like home for me. But I will always return to this church, knowing that I will always be accepted and loved for who I am unconditionally. You all have given me memories, joy, and laughter that I will never forget. And for that, I am eternally grateful. Thank you.
Good morning, St. Charles Presbyterian Church, and happy Mother's Day. It's very hard to believe that I was going to be giving the speech this way under the circumstances of COVID-19. But as a fellow believer in God, I am praying for any person deeply affected by this pandemic. Today, I am excited to tell you my church story and how it has truly changed me into the man I am today. My first experience here at St. Charles Presbyterian Church was at the age of 13 years old. Every Saturday, I would frequently always spend the night at Jacob York's house, so I guess you can say I was sort of made to come to church from Paul York. But in the end, it was the best decision he has ever made, as well as I have. As I kept coming to church with the Yorks, I kept learning more about God and more about how he truly means to us humans. I kept getting the hint that God would always be with me, and it gave me a good feeling about myself as I kept going. The big moment, however, that sparked me into coming to church more was youth group. At the time, youth group was led by Mary Kay Lyon and Margaret Osborne. which are two ladies who always sparked an interest in me and always have made sure to have nice conversations with me, as well as big hugs from Margaret. The biggest part of youth group for me was the kids I met, and Emma Carey, Zach Southard, Aaron White, and Ian Besselman. They became my friends, and they made the fun times we had together very unforgettable. And to this day, they still make me laugh. For the next 2 years, I kept coming to church, and I felt my relationship with God was getting even stronger. Then I was offered the chance to go through confirmation with everybody. At first, I was a little nervous because I did not know what the outcome would be for me. But one man was able to guide me through confirmation, and that was our very own Ronnie Osborne. He made me feel so good about myself as I kept going to church. And every sermon I'd listen to that he spoke, it gave me a better feeling of what God meant to me. I ended up finally becoming a member of the church, and to this day, it still lives on to be one of my greatest achievements in my life. I was then offered the chance to go on a mission trip that year in Chicago. That whole week brought me to the man I am today, and I was given the chance to help everyday people, and it got me even closer to God, as I already was, as well as make many memories. My fondest memory was the time when we were all gathered in this little room waiting for the arrival of the always late Jacob York. It brought out so excitement for all of us as we were all once together again. The people of this church, however, made me the man I am today and have helped me get closer to God. I'd like to say a big thank you to Mary Kay Lyon and Angie Southern, as they always felt the need to check in on me during Sunday school or church, as well as come to my outside sporting events like my cross-country meets. I'd also like to thank Margaret Osborne, as she was always wanting that big hug, and she always checked into me outside, also in school, as she put me in the PPI program at our school, which helped me become even a bigger leader. I'd also like to thank Scott Carey for making youth group as fun as it very was, as well as getting us into a big whole family. I'd also want to thank Emma Carey, as I was always there with her and always made her laugh, as well as help her with any problems that she got, especially from Zach. I'd also like to thank Ronnie Osborne, as he always was there to guide me through my relationship with God and also make me laugh. And also, he made a pathway for my parents, Meredith and Phil Gnolpho, to become members of this church, which I cannot thank him enough for. My last and biggest thank yous come in the form of four people, which are Jacob and Paul York, Zach Southard, and Aaron White. I consider us five of the Fab Five, as every step of the way we were together, whether it was youth group, mission trip, or just church itself, where we sat. This past summer, we attended the Presbyterian Youth Triennium at Purdue University, and by far, it's been one of the biggest things I've ever done in my life, and one of the most unforgettable. It was amazing to see all the other Presbyterians all around me, and the excitement was very huge with all the activities we did and all the songs we sang. I got to enjoy so many things with them, as well as meet other individuals that I also stay in contact to with this day. I'm still in contact with them every day, actually. I'd like to thank Zach and Aaron for being a big part of my life, as well as becoming one of my bestest friends. I'd also like to have a final thank you to Jacob and Paul. Without them, I don't think I'd be here, and they've been with me almost every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough. A scripture I've chosen is from John 13, verses 34 to 35. Let me give you a new command. Love another in the same way I've loved you. You love another. This is how everyone will recognize that you are disciples, when they see the love for each other. I take this scripture as an example on how I'll keep all these people in my hearts forever. In the fall, I will be attending St. Charles Community College for A+, as well as studying sports marketing. I will still be in the area, so in any given time I have, I will come back to church, as this is a second home for me, and I will always be accepted. This church has given me the best memories I could ever ask for, and I couldn't be enough thankful for everyone. Thank you, and God bless to all.
Thank you.
God's safety plan is to be his helpers, to give water for the thirsty, comfort to those who grieve, healing for ones in pain, friendship to those who are alone and are part of our lives. And part of God's plan is to offer our time and strength, as well as our money, that Christ's message and forgiveness may be shared with others. The work of the church continues even when we can't gather together Sunday mornings. Let us respond to Christ's call to love through our giving of ourselves and our offering.
Mm-hmm.
Part of our response to Christ's call to love, besides our personal devotion and God's tithes and our offerings, is a sharing of our lives with one another and then lifting one another up. So we work our way through our church directory this day. It's appropriate day. Today we remember Jim and Sandy Gino. We know that Jim got a brand new pickup truck, so I covet it. I don't know. I think Greg covets it too. He's shaking his head. So we covet that. So great. Great job. We also remember Tim and Melissa Gingrich, our younger couple here, and they've had a Miracle Max, their baby. So we remember their child, and so we're so grateful for him and how much joy he's brought all of us in this church family. And we also remember Philip and Meredith Gnolpho and Sam, and we wish Sam again happy birthday to him. And as he grows into his manhood. And so we're so grateful for all these families. And the church we're praying for is Lutzville Presbyterian Church there in Marblehead, Missouri. They're so small right now, they have no pastor, but they still have an active ministry. So remember Lutzville. And so we're so grateful. There are so many people in our midst that we're remembering that we can't be here on a regular basis. And so this is a great opportunity to reach out to our shut-ins and those in nursing homes and our seniors that can't come, especially at this time during coronavirus. There are a number of our older people that have not gone out at all, not even going into their own grocery stores. And so a phone call from you, a letter would be an awesome thing to these people. If you want to know who to write, just call the church office or text us or email us, and we'll pass this on to there. And I am also so thankful for the words of Emma and Sam that it was from their heart, and it's life-changing, I believe, and that it's definitely the word of God being preached to us today, and so we're grateful for them. So any other announcements, you can read on your church about a bulletin, and that you could download at our church directory there on our website. So let us continue worshiping in spirit and in truth and in love and in safety as we go to God in prayer. Thank you, gracious God, for making your home with us and claim us as your children. We offer ourselves and our gifts toward your plan for the new world you're trying to make among us, a world where peace emerges from respect and honest relationships. May we live out your plan to reflect your love in our attitudes and our actions. When we are together, and when we are apart. As we come together as a people of God, we lift up our prayers to the one who gives us life. We continue to pray through our church directory as we pray for three families. We pray for Jim and Sandy Gino. We also pray for Tim and Melissa Gingrich and to their miracle son, Miracle Max. We remember Phil and Meredith Gnolpho and their son, Sam. And the church from our presbytery that we pray for is Lutzville Presbyterian Church in Marblehead, Missouri, as they continue because of their size, their minimum size, without a pastor. We remember all these people, as well as our joys and concerns, as we join in the safety and blessing of a church family. Today we pray that we can begin to live out your safety plans by having an openness of heart and hands. Empower us to share your abundant life by becoming Christ's servants who reaches out to meet our neighbors in need. The need for food, clothing, shelter, for justice, for friendships, and for your amazing grace and love. So we now pray for others, especially our mothers and the women who have loved us and cared for us. In the same vein, we pray for our fathers and the men who played and strengthened us. And now we pray for those who are sick, who are sad, who are tired, and for those of us who have not had a good mom or dad and don't know how to celebrate this day. In silence, we come to you in grief and in joy. With open minds, we hear your plan to share your message of hope. With open hearts, we go to offer your abundant life to others. And with open hands, we go to offer your plan of forgiveness and love to others. And now we pray the prayer given to us to give us comfort and to make us one as we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Good news is this day in this place of safety, this place of love, this place of lifelong friendships, is that Jesus calls us to live abundantly into a world filled with grace and possibility. So go out into a world that needs our hearts and our hands, as well as our spirits. Happy Mother's Day to all you women out there. I'll see you next week.